Good morning, it's Mimi on the trail. Today is July 2nd, 2017, and I'm in the Carter Range of the White Mountains of New Hampshire. I'm going out for a solo overnight up to the Imp campsite, which is on the Appalachian Trail. Well, there's a couple reasons for that. One, I just haven't been out for a while. Another is that section of the Appalachian Trail I haven't been on yet. I'm trying to hook all the sections together so I'll eventually have all of New Hampshire. But more importantly, this is going to be a shakedown hike because next month I'm headed to the High Sierra of California. I was able to secure a permit for a section of the John Muir Trail. So today I'm going out, testing my new gear, seeing how it does. I think you should come along. So I'd say there's a fair amount of water on the trail today. Water and rocks. Welcome to the trails of New Hampshire. It is definitely a warm day. This morning when I left the house at 5:30, it was already 75 degrees. We've had a lot of rain the last few days, so the sun hitting this is just creating a lot of humidity. It's like a steam bath. But it's all good. That's why we're here. Keep going. Where I've been, and that's where I'm going. Well, this is a very pretty part of the trail. I made a turn and came around the shoulder of this mountain, and all of a sudden there's moss and more running water. It's just beautiful. There's some dwarf Cornel in bloom. Okay, I'm approaching the ridge now, but I just wanted to show you, this is the trail I've been walking on. And I turned around, and this is my first view back. Got a little bit of a view back to the Presidential Range. Getting a little bit of elevation, so I think I'm getting close to the ridge. I'm at the junction with the Appalachian Trail, also known as the Carter-Moriah Trail. Now, I've been here quite a few times before, several snowshoe hikes, as a matter of fact, in January and February, and the snowpack is sometimes so deep that these signs are barely peeking over the top of the snow. And in past, I've always gone to the south, that direction, or come in from that way. But today, I am heading north. I am going down the Appalachian Trail in that direction to the Imp Shelter. Now I'm going to sit here. It's noon. I'm going to have a little lunch, which is a tuna pouch with mayo and pickle relish, some snacks, have a little water, and then head for the shelter. So I just broke through the trees. This is where I came from, along that ridge right there. And there's the Carters there into this beautiful view. Look at that. Gorgeous. Now here's an interesting part of the trail. I just came down this. There's water flowing down. It's a pretty sheer face. Took a little bit of handholds and a little bit of rock climbing to get down that safely, but I knew the trail dropped off pretty sharply after the summit of North Carter. I could tell that from the topography, but that was a challenge, and this hasn't been the only one. There's been quite a few of those along the way, so hopefully I'll be getting out of that and the trail will level out a little bit as I make my way over to the campsite. Oh, another beautiful vista. And down here is the trail. So here we go, just keep descending and descending and descending. But what a view. That's where I just came. You can see that sharp descent coming down. I'll tell you what, I have hiked a lot of miles up here, and that was a sharp downward decline off of North Carter. It took me an hour of just slabbing downhill, and it was watery and muddy and slick, and you had to find any handhold or route possible. But we made it, and I've leveled out now, and I know I'm getting close to the Imp Shelter, and this is a great viewpoint. The wind's kicked up a little bit, but it actually feels very refreshing. It's been a hot day. Well, I met some really interesting people on the trail. I met two southbounders, and I just ran into a man who was with the Forest Service. Had a nice conversation with him. He was out on a two-day patrol. I guess he just walks the ridge, checks out everything. He said he just came from Imp Shelter, and that I would be there shortly. So that's something to look forward to. But here we are in another interesting section. Looks like a sidewalk of granite. Okay, here is my home for the night. I'm on tent platform number one, the furthest away from the camp, the caretaker. And this is my Copper Spur UL1 from Big Agnes. And I had to really hustle to get this thing set up. The wind's died down a little bit now, but when I was putting this up, it was whipping pretty good. It was quite a challenge to get it secured down and guide out. And I think I got it pretty well secure for the night. And I haven't rearranged much of anything in here because, again, I had to throw things in here just to weight it down. But here is my quilt. I just unpacked that from the compression sack, letting that fluff up a little bit. Various odds and ends. I have my battery pack up there. My Garmin's already charging. And I think I'm gonna head off now and filter some water. Okay, I've got my pack hung up for the night, and I've got my water filtering my gravity system with my Sawyer squeeze, and I think I'm going to head over and have a little dinner. It's about 6:30. There's an area set up, there's a tarp they put up that's the cooking and eating area, and it's over by the shelter. That way it keeps all the food smells in one area. So I'm going to head over there and have some dinner. Well, good morning. I am sitting here overlooking this beautiful scene, blue sky, puffy clouds. I've been up for a while. I broke my tent down, but now I'm over having my breakfast. And that is some homemade dehydrated hash browns, ham, a little bit of country gravy in there, and a packet of sriracha. Let that hydrate for a few minutes. Very, very good on a cool morning. This area down here has been set up for cooking and eating. There's a tarp up there. I'm not sure you can see it, but that will allow everybody to come down, even if the weather's bad, and cook and eat down here. And that way it consolidates the food smells and makes for a cleaner camp. Anyway, I'm going to sit here, finish my breakfast. I've got some coffee, and then I'm going to pack up and head out. And I'm going to be going back the same trail that I came in on. Talk to you later. I'm almost back to the car. It has been a great overnight trip, and I'm really happy with the way my gear performed as well. My tent, the Big Agnes Copper Spur UL1, did a great job. Now, we've had a lot of rain here in New Hampshire, so the woods are wet. There's water on the trail, been very humid, and last night the temperatures dropped, but I didn't have any condensation. But I made sure that I guide out those tent corners of the fly really, really tightly, because I think that really helps with airflow. The other thing I didn't talk about was my shoes. I have a new pair of trail runners. Let me turn the camera around here for you. Those are the Ultra Loma 3.0 zero heel drop shoe. And the only thing I can say about those is, where have you been my whole life? My feet feel fantastic, and my feet always hurt when I hike, sometimes quite painfully, but these were a win. Anyway, that's all for now. I'm almost to the car. Until next time, Mimi signing out.